Hi and welcome to POCUS Geek. My name is Jared Marks, and in this video we're going to discuss soft tissue ultrasound and identifying clotted vessels. So typically when we talk about a clotted vessel, we're going to be discussing veins, and we're going to need to differentiate a superficial vein versus a deep vein since the treatment is a little bit different. So a superficial vein is located in the subcutaneous tissue, typically superficial to the fascial layer, or it should be superficial to the fascial layer, and it does not travel with an artery. Whereas a deep vein will typically be under a fascial plane and it travels in conjunction with an artery. This is important because the treatment's definitely different for the two of them. Now, we're gonna always look at normal tissue first. This is the same image we've seen in many of the other videos of soft tissue ultrasound. And the key is understanding this fascial plane, and what we're gonna look at is in here. If a vein's up in that area, it's typically going to be a superficial vein. You're going to want to identify if there's an artery traveling with it. If it's traveling solo, then it's going to be a superficial vein. Whereas if we're down in this area below the fascial plane, coursing between muscles, won't go in the muscle, but between muscles, that's going to be a deep vein, and the treatment's a little bit different for that. This is just a long access of the same area, showing once again our fascial plane right here. This is our superficial tissue where we're going to watch for superficial veins, and deep here in red is our muscle. And we may see in between muscles a vein or artery. But remember, deep veins travel with arteries. So a lot of our typical symptoms of a DVT are similar to that of superficial thrombophlebitis, which is the same as abscess or and or cellulitis, other types of soft tissue infection, or just straight up edema. So we're going to review how to differentiate some of this. Now remember that soft tissue edema is nonspecific. It can happen in any type of tissue edema. That could be dependent edema in the lower extremities, venous insufficiency, it's all the same. Or it can be cellulitis, but loss of tissue differentiation is what you're going to look at. And the area is going to be hyperechoic, but it is not specific to any one type of etiology. They all look the same. So when we look here, we can see normal tissue with a fascial plane here and here. And then superficial to it, we can see the subcutaneous tissue or fat tissue. And we can tell on this side it's affected, it's deeper. And not only is it deeper, but there's loss of tissue differentiation, and this whole area is more hyperechoic than the normal side that we see on the left side of the screen. So let's look at those two videos. We can see some areas of anechoic structures in the right, but that's early cobblestoning, which we've reviewed in other videos. So if you haven't watched those, go ahead and go back and watch those to understand that more fully. Whereas on the left, we're seeing normal tissue, and that's adipose tissue. So why is it important that we understand what a clotted vessel looks like? So unfortunately, I've seen in the past where people have misidentified this as abscess. And started antibiotics or even attempted INDs. So it's important that we understand what a clotted vessel looks like. So this is back to the patient that we've seen through many of the videos, and she complained of pain, redness, swelling, and increased warmth to this area of her posterior left leg. She was a housekeeper who had been up and down on step stools, had been working on her knees, cleaning floors, and had developed some pain a few days previously, and the pain seemed to be isolated to this area only. This is her normal right leg posterior. It's the same images we've been looking at throughout these lectures, and we can see the fascial plane right here, and then her normal subcutaneous tissue. This one is a transverse view over here, and then this one over here is a long axis. Okay. So when we look at the affected tissue in a transverse view, what we can see is our fascial plane right along here. All this superficial is the subcutaneous tissue. It is a little hyperechoic. And we see this anechoic structure here. You can see some echoes inside of it, but what we notice is some pressure is being placed on it, as we can see these tissues shortening. However, this vein is not collapsing. Things that tell this is not an artery, it's superficial to the fascial plane. It's in just a subcutaneous tissue. On the leg, we need to know our anatomy also, and there's no artery that would be traveling in this position. Same thing, we're going to see the confluence of that vein that we saw in the previous video come back down, and it's becoming confluent with the vein here and here. And we can tell as we put compression on this, as this shortens on the sides, that those are not compressible. The veins are not winking at us. In the next image, we're going to follow this vein off to the right, and we're going to see that it continues to not collapse over in here. And we can see some suggestion of echoes in there just briefly. And this is concern for a clot, mostly because it's not collapsing, not because we see echoes. Sometimes we may not. Also, in addition, we don't want to confuse these for lymphadenopathy. Lymphadenopathy could be a chain of lymph nodes, but they will be separate. This structure is all contiguous when we do this scan, and we've been able to track this vein. Now, eventually, we can track it to an area where we can compress and see it wink at us, and that helps us know that this is a vein that we're looking at. Also, following the course of it can help us know that it's an isolated vein and not an abscess. Additionally, we can tell that it has well-defined walls and that it is not dissecting in and through the tissues like an abscess would. Now, that can be confusing because if we look at something like this right here, we can see that we can see the structure and get concerned, well, could that be an abscess? Well, what goes against that, like I said just a moment ago, is this does not have irregular walls. We can see that structure. This is actually clot, so don't get that mistaken for irregular walls. And it's non-compressible. Even an abscess should compress some and have some swirling in it, which is discussed in a previous lecture. Here's one more of just following the course of the vein over a length of period. You could also try to rotate this out to long access. That's not discussed in this video, but rotating out to long access will show you that it's a nice cylindrical continuous structure, and that will further help you to define it as a vein. I hope this video was helpful to you for those of you that are performing soft tissue ultrasound. If you have any questions about this or other point of care ultrasound related questions, please reach out to me at pocusgeek@gmail.com or comment below. And have a great day.